All right, everybody, welcome to another great episode of the Leave It to Beaver podcast. I am John, aka Wally, and here with me, as always, is my partner in crime, my wonderful father, Stan, aka Ward. How you doing today?
Oh, man, I'm just doing great. I'm over the big COVID from a couple of weeks ago, and as a reward to myself, I was just telling John, you abruptly started our show. But I bought myself a brand new Fender Player Telecaster. Ooh. To go with my brand new Marshall amp.
Wow. You excited to play that?
Oh, man. I have a lot of great guitars, but I got into wanting to play the Telecaster and played the one that I rebuilt and want a new one.
How many guitars do you have now?
Well, I think I've gotten nine. I just sold two.
Oh,
so right. I think I'll be back up to about 11 or 12.
Oh, very nice.
I sold that Gibson for some big change.
Yeah, you love that one, though.
Yeah, but I didn't play it. It was as much. I get a lot of arthritis in my hand and has a wide radius on the neck of the guitar.
So
it needs to be played by somebody. And that's like a $4,000 guitar.
So
Yeah. Woo. I got some good change for that when I sold it.
So you got to treat yourself when you sell something.
Well, good. I did. I had to give some to your mom and everything else. I didn't have to, but I did.
They always kind of.
I gave her a couple of G's.
The old ladies always take that.
I gave her a couple of G's.
You know, so if I went up to her and asked her, would she say the story is true?
The story is true about what?
That you're giving her a couple of G's?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, yeah, man.
All right. We'll see.
She actually made me get that Fender today, like June Cleaver.
Look at her.
She said, hey, man, you know, you're getting long in the tooth there. You're 73, man. You want that guitar?
We need to get you a new hunting jacket next.
Yeah, man. I needed a new. Hey, I'll get you a piggy bank, man.
Well, we got a great show tonight planned. Yes. It's called Poncho. That's the title.
Poncho, man.
Poncho. Well, just to get the housekeeping out of the way early, we really appreciate everybody coming out and checking out the show. As always, we hope you came out and joined us on Wednesday. Yeah. We do a Wednesday show now. We do a second episode every week. It's not live typically, so... You know, when we do those are pre-taped out. So we just let you know ahead of time. If we don't respond right away on the questions on there, or we don't read them out loud here when we're live, it's not us slighting you, or it's not us not reading them. We check out everything. It's just that we weren't live. So that's why we didn't talk about it on air. So we usually let you know when we're not live right ahead of time. But usually count on Saturdays being live always, and as long as we can. And Wednesdays typically will not be live. So we will have a second show every week. Make sure if you're watching on YouTube or Facebook or whatever you're checking it out on, that you hit the like and follow button on Facebook. You subscribe and hit that bell and notification on YouTube. And you can also get it on audio. Yeah. All major podcast outlets, Apple, iTunes, Spotify, iHeart Radio, TuneIn. I mean, I could go down the list. There's a million of them out there. Yeah. You can go find it for yourself out there. It's right available shortly right after each episode airs. What is the synopsis for tonight, now that I got all that out of the way?
This is a tearjerker. I have to tell you that. So
that's what you were saying last night.
And this and the next show that we're going to do on Beaver versus the State.
Beaver versus the State.
They have some tearjerkers. But this one with Poncho, I guess because it reminds me of my little dog, Bernie.
Uh-huh.
But it's got a lot of morality in here between Ward and June and everything else. But the long and short of it is Beaver bring home I'm starting to talk like him now. Beaver brings home and bonds with a runaway chihuahua, but he has to give up the little dog when the rightful owner answers an ad in the paper. And this is typical. We were just talking about this and something else. This is the beauty of Leave It to Beaver, man. the morale. These guys, you know, this show, the next show, all the shows, they're always doing the right thing. And, you know, this kid loves this dog. And we've all had a dog or a bird or something that comes to the house and you want to take care of it and keep it. Maybe it belongs to somebody else. It comes with a lot of baggage with it. And this show gets into it.
And you are, like I am, just an avid animal lover.
Oh, yeah. I've done that. I've had animals that, you know, we've done this with and they go away or they die or they fly away like the birds.
The baby Heckle bird. And Jekyll.
Heckle and Jekyll. I was the Birdman of Alcatraz. My wife brought him home. No kidding. I'm lucky I was the director in my job. I would bring him in a little Easter basket. People would say, I hear birds chirping and Stan's office.
Well, they had a dog that they got in the Captain Jack episode, but we never saw that dog again.
Yeah, and people say in the synopsis of this that when Ward admonishes Beaver about taking care of the dog, he's referring to that dog.
Uh-huh.
Or whatever, I don't know.
Oh, man. But I love it.
I bet you guys, when you were kids, you must have had some kind of critter that you brought home. And I see a lot of people in our demographics are 50 and above. You know, you must have kids or grandkids of your own. And you must have faced this kind of thing a million times.
At least once in a while. It's somebody's had to have faced this situation.
How many animals would you see left on our doorstep?
Oh, man, we had it a bunch of times.
Yeah, I just name them and bring them in the house.
I just had it when I moved into the house down the street from you there about 5 years ago with my cat, Thea. And I'd like to thank Mom for that one. You know, she came up to me and said, wife, had found the cat in the graveyard. It was about 6 weeks old. Yeah. I already had three cats at the time and two dogs. And it's so cute. And then here was Mom saying, you need to keep it now. Yep. I'm not keeping it. No. Boom. Yep. What happened? I kept it.
Yeah, I had the same
cat. Was at the vet the next day getting shots and checked out. And 5+ years later, we still got it.
I had a big brand new 2-car garage put in, brand new driveway, everything, brand new garage doors, put my nice cars in there. And what happens? We have all dogs and cats in the house, and then my wife does the same thing. Find some cats. I fall in love with them. What do? I can't pull the cars in. I got to have the cats in there with a kerosene heater. And it looked like the bulldogs playing poker with everything. There's all the neighborhood cats are in there.
I think we've all had something like that at some point.
Yeah, I never got to put my car in the garage in winter.
To this day, that side is still filled up over there.
Stuff.
Yeah, well, that's the way that it goes. That's the way the cookie crumbles, so to speak.
Cost me 14 G's for a cat.
Uh-huh. It usually works out. Yeah, it usually works out that way sometimes, right?
There you go.
All right, so you ready to get on into it, buddy?
I'm ready to roll. I hope you guys didn't mind our true life stories here. Shows you the real common sense of being a psychologist.
Oh, absolutely. Yes. Well, we are getting started right here on episode 23. It is Poncho. And you can watch it on any app that it's out there on. Roku, Tubi, Peacock, whatever it might be.
Here we go. I'm going to skip the intro here.
We are kicking it in.
Starring Barbara Billings. Well, it's too late to do that.
It'll hit us a commercial almost instantly. All right. We got a comment here from V1954. Says, my husband had a little dog and brought him to school. He was in the second grade, and the teacher told him to bring Budgie home. This was in 1958 Long Island, where kids could walk home by themselves. See?
Yep.
Another one that happens out there that has happened to as well.
Here we go. They're having an inspection at school. Uh-huh. Molly tells Beaver, what does he have? He's got a dog in there.
Oh, it's raining in Mayfield here.
Oh, man, it's a rainy night.
Look at June. She's just out there staring at it. That's quite dark out right there for after school. Hello, Miss Devra. How are you doing tonight? Dad. Wonderful to see you.
Ward never gets bothered by anything.
Nah, he doesn't. He's pretty much a cool customer most of the time. Most of the time is the key word.
Now he sees him jumping in the puddle, so he knows it's his kid.
Uh-huh.
Watch this now.
It's great to see you as well, Deborah. Thank you so much for being here tonight. Thank you to everybody else for joining us. It's great to see you out. Drop your comments on whatever you're watching as we go through the show tonight. We'd love to hear from you.
Do you guys ever do that? I can remember doing that. Jumping in puddles with my shoes.
June looks like she's got about ready to kill him there for getting her floor all wet.
Well, he started to. Then it got kind of wet while we were watching some men take a car out of the mud.
Hey, Barbara, how's it going? Oh, we just started. You're just a couple minutes. You're good.
Yeah, this is Barb. This is where Beaver finds a stray dog.
Poncho.
Poncho. Here he is.
What is that hat he's wearing?
Those are the rain slicks that people used to have. In the
My
classes.
Gosh, he looks like he was a Vietnamese soldier.
He looks like a Gloucester fisherman.
I know, but the way the hat is, it's like one of those Vietnamese hats that, you know, the Vietnamese soldiers you'd see him wearing.
Oh, now here's Ward. He hasn't fooled Ward.
No. I suppose he has in the jacket. Look at him. He's good. Sure, he's hiding something. He is good.
There it is.
He's
There's
cute.
Poncho. Yeah.
What is it? You know why? It's a dog.
Poncho's cute.
Yes. He looks a little like Bernie. Can hear
us. Remember, Grandma had that that Christian gave Roscoe. That Chihuahua was evil, though. He bit me.
Yeah, Roscoe.
He bit me. I just went to go pet the son of a gun, and he bit me. They fed him to death.
They did, actually.
He lived a good life after being abused for years with those two.
Yes, he actually got diabetes. That's what he died from.
He did not look like a Chihuahua by the time they were done with him. He lived a good life after being a left and abused animal for them.
Now look at this here. How many times have you had a kid or a grandkid or you or that person?
Hey, George, how's it going tonight? Great to see you out, my friend. Chihuahuas are cute dogs, though.
Yeah, they really are.
They are. Oh, see? They did not leave that stone unturned.
No, Ward. You're going to see this in the next episode.
But anyway, a dog like this obviously belongs to somebody.
Nothing to show who it belongs to.
Well, I know you don't quite understand, Beaver, but believe me, the only right thing to do is to find out who owns the dog.
Yeah, dogs like that typically aren't left stray either. No. They must have been expensive dogs prior to that point
in
time.
They were expensive when I was
there. They're still expensive dogs to this day.
Yeah,
I can understand.
He is a cute little dog, though.
He does look like Roscoe, though.
He does.
I have to work well tomorrow, so. In the morning, I'll take Bill Wally by the newspaper office, and you can place an ad in the Lost and Found.
Ah, the old days when you go and do the Lost and
can
Found.
Can you imagine? And these were real days.
Yeah.
And at least in my life, you could go to the Lost and Found, or you go to the police precinct or something, and walk in. Oh my God.
Those are the days, right? He is so calm, cool, and collective over this all right here.
He enjoys this.
You know.
Here's his story.
A duck?
A duck.
Yeah.
The lake was frozen over and it was wandering around on the ice.
Did you ever have a pet duck?
No. But we did have a kid who had one in the area, and then his mother killed it and ate it. These Italian people.
Father's best imported sardines.
And then? Your favorite sardines,
yeah. Sun came and it flew away. That's when I learned that to a duck, there's no such thing as gratitude.
Ducks are kind of mean animals, though.
No, they imprint on you like geese and things like that.
The Courier Sun newspaper.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I found a dog. The dog is a chi.
I squashed that out.
Oh, yes. The dog is brownish with no
Look at
hair.
This, how people helped people in the days. The librarians were that way.
His because Whitey found him in his garbage pail.
He means eating out of his garbage pail.
Oh, I see.
This nice lady at the paper is going to help correct it here.
Yes.
I found. I'm the one who found it. Signed, Beaver Cleaver.
Young man, did you write this all by yourself?
No, my brother here helped me with it.
He's so proud saying that his brother helped him with it. See, Barbara says, I usually find that the animal episodes are not as enjoyable. This is one I really do like. Yeah, this is so far so good.
Yeah.
The Captain Jack one was good, though.
Yes.
I like that one.
Well, I'm very sorry, sir, but I'm afraid it's not your dog. Well, I can appreciate how anxious you are to locate Frederick the Third, but I'm
Frederick the Third.
On the Chihuahua. Not at all. Good night.
They're going to be getting a lot of calls there for that dog.
Mm-hmm. You know that makes the 14th call in 2 days.
Must be the time of year.
Boy, June's got it all. She knows every single call that's coming into that house.
And there's their evening. There's no television.
Yep.
No, they're sitting there talking.
She's knitting.
Yep. I think they're giving him a bath. You know, even Wally's grown attached to him.
Well, I saw his muddy face that first night.
They don't really mention television too much in the show.
No.
You know, later on in the episodes, he has the TV in the den or something like that. Or he says, or he mentions that.
Yeah.
You know, like Cesar Romero.
Well, I think I'll take the ad out of the paper tomorrow.
He kind of likes the dog.
He does. He wants to kind of keep
him. Yeah, he wants to keep him.
You know.
But he's doing the right thing.
She's knitting a sweater for the dog.
He looks kind of small.
Oh, honey, calm down. For the dog.
Yep.
See, everybody.
Everybody wants to keep the dog.
Everybody wants to keep the dog. They're nice people.
They all do.
Now, here's the real world coming in.
Hello.
Giving him a bath in the sink.
Yeah, this is a fast episode, man. It really flies by.
George says Poncho's owner is a mean old lady, as I recall.
Not too much, George, but she's a famous character actress.
I'm interested to see her now to determine this.
Yes. She's kind of clueless.
He's adorable. He looks like my dog Sawyer when you give him a bath and he's not all fluffed out.
Yeah, this is when Beaver was very adorable.
Yeah,
what an adorable child.
Yeah, if the right one doesn't show up, you think Dad will let me keep the dog?
I wouldn't be surprised. I know Dad's kind of old, but he probably remembers when he was a kid.
Yes, Mrs. Bennett. Tomorrow morning will be fine. Oh, that's perfectly all right.
Aww.
He sounds like the right one.
She described him to a T.
Wart's kind of disappointed here.
Oh, yeah.
She's going to pick him up in the morning.
Were the Beavers going to be heartbroken?
They're both kind of disappointed here, I think.
Oh, yeah, but Ward knows how life is.
Burba says, not mean, just cranky.
Yes.
Clueless is a better description, George said he meant. I really liked a lot of the first season stuff because I've never seen it and I don't remember it.
Yeah.
I've always seen all the other seasons a bunch of times, but... Yeah. I love these ones, kind of seeing them for the first time.
Well, look at this. Look,
he's sad.
Oh, they got everything.
Yeah.
I just want my dog.
The Beaver, if it's her dog, you're just going to have to give it back to her.
Yeah.
That's what this show is all about, these lessons in life. You don't find somebody to cheat somebody.
But she hasn't seen it. Maybe it's still the wrong dog.
No, I don't think so, Beaver. Well, I've got to get my breakfast. You boys better get on to school.
Oh, poor Beav.
She said the dog's name was Poncho.
Yeah, it's a wonderful thing about this show. Psychologically, if it's bad news, these guys tell you the truth.
Yeah.
You know, they tell you the truth, but they're there for you to help you work through dealing with the way the world is.
Yeah.
Not the way you want to cheat it or make it out to be. It's not. They deal in reality here.
Yeah.
Poncho belongs to somebody else.
It's got to go back.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not yours. Ward was always good as a realist, though. He never beat around the bush with them too much.
I think that comes from his background as a minister. I think that really shows in the show. They write that to him. I hate to say that. I don't mean to, you know, start preaching, but...
Look at him in that box that they gave him there.
Tell me this is a really great acting, though.
Hey, dog.
It's just really nicely done.
He's got to check out the name if it's Poncho.
You got it.
Yeah, Prince. Yes, boy.
There he goes. Come on, do it.
Yep.
Yep, Poncho.
No, there he goes. Oh, yep. Now he knows it's official.
And what is he going to do?
George says, isn't this where Beaver takes the dog to school in his jacket?
Absolutely,
yes, sir.
Absolutely, George. Yep. You got it, man.
Yep.
No spoilers here.
Quick commercial here, folks. We got 1 minute.
Do you know, I can remember watching The Wonderful World of Disney when it first came on television and watching Pinocchio.
Mm-hmm.
And my mother would come in every night and tuck me in before I'd go to sleep. Jeez, I think until I went in the Army. But she'd always come in and tuck me in and then say, remember, I swear to God, guys,
let your conscience be your guide.
Yep. I can't tell you how many times I'd want to lie in life or being a big, you know, just like anybody else. And I could picture my mother saying,
I knew it before you even said it.
Yeah.
Yep. She was a great woman, too.
Oh, absolutely.
Gosh.
Absolutely.
She was a great woman.
No BS in there, man. It's very simple lessons, just like this.
Barbara says, I often think my cats don't know their names, and I do this too. Gosh, mine might know their names too easy. Oh, look at this lady. I've looked for that dog in the garage and in the basement, and this is the second time I've looked through the boys' room. Well, your husband assured me Poncho would be here. I was out of town, and I was so upset when I got back to find out that Poncho would run away. I just know that cleaning woman let him out. She doesn't like dogs. Of course, I've never treated Poncho as a dog at all. He's always been one of the family. I can't imagine. Is she wearing a mink stole?
Yeah. People used to wear that. My goodness, that was a big deal. Chinchilla.
I never had any children. Except
Poncho. Poncho is this lady's child.
Yes, she's a spinster.
Yep.
I
hope he hasn't run away again. That's the way we all have our poor memorized. Miss Canfield.
And here's how the whole system works, man, in this thing. Forgive me for being the interpreter here, but everybody gets in on the morality lesson here, including Miss Canfield.
We haven't seen her in a while.
No, and she's got quite a dilemma here. The skip I take his little daughter Bear and Company.
Oh, that's very nice, Whitey. I love Whitey.
That's what people used to call me when I was a kid, because he had blonde hair. Whitey.
Jesus. What happened to that blonde hair?
Turned gray, man.
Uh-huh.
Larry, how about you?
Larry's thinking about brownies and apples.
See, Beaver and Larry are like me and Lisha.
Uh-huh. I was sick when he gave out the assignment. Here's Judy.
A skipper is the man who runs the ship, and Larry was not sick when he gave out the assignment.
Simon.
I think she's the most obnoxious character on the whole show.
A little bit.
But she plays a good part, at least.
Cheeks like the dawn of day.
That is an outfit that kid is wearing.
Oh, yeah, that she would have been a doll, let me tell you.
What was that?
This time period.
Theodore, are you making noises?
No, Miss Canfield.
All right, Linda, go on.
And her bosom white as a hop on buds that oak in the month of May.
Oh, boy.
Just who is making the noise?
It came out of Beaver, Miss Canfield.
Oh, my.
Is that right, Beaver?
He's met with Larry.
Uh-huh.
Well, came out of me, but I didn't make it.
Do you have something in your jacket?
You mean beside me?
Miss Canfield is wonderful.
Yeah.
She's so patient. With
she's a wonderful teacher, yes. Too. I love Miss Landers later on, too.
Yes.
Oh, look at him. He is adorable, Poncho.
This episode is a great, it's a real tearjerker.
I know, but he's so small. He's hardly a dog at all.
Boy, that's a small class.
Yeah. Just enough to get into the shop there.
Yep. Barbara says, Judy is an amazing character they added to this show. Brilliant.
Yes.
She's the great antagonist for all the kids in school.
Yes.
She plays that obnoxious student role so perfect, Barbara. I'm
waiting for an explanation. Thank you, Wes.
I hate that with what they do with his vocabulary.
Yeah.
I really don't like that.
I'm with you on that one. That, and I noticed on the show, when I was doing the shows, He lies all the time.
Yeah, all the time.
All the time.
He's like a compulsive liar.
Yeah. But I think that's the way they saw little boys.
Yeah.
At the time, where they were tale tellers.
You were his age at this time. Were you like that?
No.
Yeah.
No.
You mean your father doesn't like dogs?
No. I mean, yes.
But now that I think of it, yeah, we would try and get things over on adults all the time by BSing them.
Yeah.
Yeah. I have to take that back.
Because Dad's going to get Poncho to a mean old lady who hates dogs.
Well, if she hates dogs, why is she going to take him?
I guess we'll have something to be mean to.
Theodore, are you telling me the truth?
Miss Canfield can spot the lie a mile away. She's good at it by now.
The truth is the issue here.
Yep.
Doing the right thing.
Well, I think we better take the dog and go down to Mrs. Rayburn's office.
You're raised by a village in the show.
Pacho's kind of fallen asleep there at some points.
But I thought you were my friend.
Well, I am your friend, Beaver. That's one of the reasons I'm taking you to Mrs. Rayburn's office. Do you understand?
Can you imagine trying to tell somebody today this?
No.
That the reason that you have consequences to your behavior, you have to go up in your room, or you have to go to the principal's office because I am your friend.
I'm sorry, Dallas, but we can't have this kind of slipshod work. Look, you had the papers on this 2 weeks ago. There's no reason for these delays. They're costing us money. Wait just a minute. Yeah? Who? Mrs. Rayburn.
Look at that phone system he's got there.
Oh, yeah.
All right, put her on.
That was the phone systems people had years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, Mrs. Rayburn.
Mr. Keever, I wonder if you could come down to school. It's about Theodore. Yes, I think you should. You see, he brought a dog with him to school today.
Mrs. Rayburn, he couldn't have brought a dog to school. You see, a woman was coming by.
I can imagine
house
trying to get my father to go down to leave his job to go down to school because I brought a dog to school.
I don't think he would have, would he?
No, he would have said, "Hey, what's the matter with you? Just tell him, take the dog and bring it."
Tell that humphead to bring the dog.
My father called everybody a humphead.
Yep. Tell him to bring the dog home. Listen to the music.
Yeah.
Dom, dom, da, dom.
The funeral march.
Yep.
Gather, Mrs. Rayburn got in touch with you.
She certainly did. Beaver, go on upstairs to your room and wait until I call you.
Yes, Dad.
Molly, you better go too.
He didn't even do anything.
Uh-huh. He's not messing around now.
This is funny.
You're not mad at me too, are you?
What did he do? Nothing.
Poor kid. He didn't do anything.
June, do you mean to tell me that Mrs. Rayburn called here first?
Yes, but I thought you could handle it better.
Ooh.
She used to be one of my teachers, and she still makes me nervous.
I have had a delightful afternoon. I had to cancel a business conference in order to go over to school and find out my son has no respect for the truth.
That's the issue.
Before you go up there and punish him, why don't we try to figure out why he did it?
What is there to figure out? He did it because he wanted to keep somebody else's dog.
I think he did it because he felt the dog loved him very much, and that was something he needed.
She's sympathizing well with him.
Yeah. What do you mean he needs love? He's got parents, hasn't he? Don't we love him?
Yes, but it's different for the little
boy. He's very perturbed by the fact that he had to leave the office, too.
But he's having a hard time adjusting to the new narrative of the 50s.
Yeah.
The psychobabble at that time.
Yep.
I think you're dramatizing Beaver's motive, so I'll go easy on him. Let's face it, he practically stole a dog.
Boy, they're having kind of a knockdown drag out here for them.
Because these are important values to him. He's bitching out the guy at work for not doing his job because of the money. He doesn't want his kids to do that.
Well, as a matter of fact, we have Mrs. Bennett. Oh, this is my husband, Mr. Cleaver.
How do you
do? This is Poncho's mother. Ward, would you get the boys, please?
Ward is so gracious.
I love how she just said his mother. I mean his owner. Aw, poor kid. He's going to lose Poncho now.
Yeah,
Molly, would you bring her downstairs, please?
Yes, Dad.
Yes, Dad.
See, he's smart enough to not have Beaver have to do this.
Yeah. It's like taking the long walk to the execution.
Yeah, absolutely.
I want you to come down and apologize to Mrs. Bennett.
Do I got it, Dad? Seems like I'm apologizing to just about everybody I know today.
I'd like to give your boy a reward. Would you think a dollar would be sufficient for the little fellow?
A dollar?
It's very nice of you, Mrs. Bennett, but in view of what happened, I don't think he...
Well, that was a lot of money back then.
Uh-huh. With that mink stole she's got on, she can afford more than a dollar.
Well, I think that's the drift on it.
Uh-huh.
Shame on you for running away from these nice people.
He didn't run away from us.
Cranky old lady definitely is a good analogy for her. She's kind of a wacko.
Why in the world would you do that, little boy?
Well, you see, I knew I was going to have to give him back to you.
Oh, poor kid. I sympathize with him, too.
So I took him to school because I figured if I kept him a little longer, he might remember me a little better.
Aww.
She doesn't get it.
No. Ward does, though, right now.
You will never understand children.
There you go.
Mm-hmm.
They think concretely.
Yeah.
I'm thinking rights and wrongs.
You saw it click in Ward's head, though, in that instance there, you know, like where he was hot and ticked off at Beaver. Look at her giving him the look now.
Dad, should I go to my room now?
Yeah.
He makes him go, because he's supposed to.
Yeah. He doesn't know how to handle this one right now.
It's a critical thinking exercise, a learning exercise here.
George said, invariably to me, June would get involved in things when she shouldn't. Sometimes, yes, definitely, George. I agree. Occasionally, yep.
I'm sure glad it didn't go over mine.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to, the same thing like he wants his kids to learn, he wants to be a good father.
Yeah. He wants to kind of give him a little bit of leeway here in this instance, but I think he knows he doesn't have to. But he brought, you know, that he should give them a little leeway, maybe, but I don't know if he's going to.
I see his real Puritan values of the 50s, and I think his background as a Methodist minister and everything else like that. The way to hell is paved with good intentions.
Yeah, sometimes.
You know, so better to, and we'll see in the next show.
Yeah.
A lot of people in those days felt, hey, like the teacher says, the reason I am your friend, Beaver,
is because I'm doing.
That's what I'm doing. I'm being your friend.
God, if we had the values of this period of time more today, it would be sure nice to see. We got about 10 seconds left on this commercial break here before we wrap up on
great
this episode,
show.
Folks.
The ending of this is really important.
Yeah, I'm interested to see.
There's a one-liner from Wally coming up here.
All right, here we are.
Home. So we are.
He's stuffing that fruit in his pockets there.
How school? You know. We're here. We stayed after school. He wanted to talk to Miss Canfield.
You mean Gene A's day after?
No, he just wanted to tell us something.
Yeah, they want to make everything right.
He was trying to get after them. What is up?
Boy, it's like this kid hasn't eaten in ages.
No, he's an active kid. He can eat all he wants.
Don't you miss those days?
Yeah. Watch this now. This is really beautiful.
Look at the fountain pen that she has there.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Beaver. You still at school?
Yes, Miss Campbell. I'm still at school.
I just wanted to let you know, I'm not mad at you for squealing on me yesterday.
Oh, well, I'm glad to know that, Beaver. You know, I have rules I must follow, too.
Yep.
Well, sure. I understand now. If you hadn't have done it, I would have gotten away with something. It would have gotten me a lot worse in trouble.
Yeah,
he gets it.
He gets it.
He gets it.
Everybody does it with love.
You don't want to accept it in that moment, but the reality is you know that it's the right thing.
A good chance you'll keep out of.
You know it's the right thing.
She's just saying it. You can take a look here. Little problems, the big ones, maybe get taken care of.
Good night, Beaver.
And there's a lovely thing that Wally says to Ward at the end of this. Boy, tell me these shows don't have a lot of meaning, man.
Good moral fiber to them, always.
Yeah, they sure do. Oh, it's the next one where Wally has a big line. Forgive me.
That was a great episode, though.
Wasn't it a real great tearjerker?
That was a great episode, though. I really liked that
one. How did you guys like this one? Did you care for it a lot?
I thought that was a really good one. That Poncho is one cute dog, though, man. I want to go take Poncho, too.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed that one, too. I mean, I enjoy every one of the episodes that they do. It's just great lessons and great things that, you know, you see out there. Hard lessons that you see for them sometimes. Deborah said, great lesson here. Really good one. Yeah, I would agree, Deborah. I thought it was a really, really good lesson on that one, too. I give that episode a thumbs up all day.
You know, that's what I love about this show. We were talking, John and I were talking before the show. I was talking with some friends today about different narratives we hear in our world in 2023, and you know, in 2023. And boy, I want to thank all of you guys for coming out to the show and making your comments and everything else like that. Because what a wonderful way to get a shared sense of reality. The world is no different than it was for Beaver.
Absolutely.
I mean, the world is different, but I mean, the values are not really different.
Gene Pride says the same thing. Great to see you out, Gene. I think the first time we've seen you on here, but it's great to see you out. Yes. It was a good one.
Fantastic.
V1954 said, love this episode. Sometimes obeying the rules can be tough.
Hey, can I throw something in for V1954?
Yep.
John always says to me, is there something that you want to say at the end of the show? Do you mind if I did one?
No,
one
absolutely.
I thought it might be nice every once in a while on a show to have some things that Ward Cleaver says. Some wise words from Ward.
Yep.
And V1954, just what we're talking about. Here's what Ward says, one of his famous quotes. You're not going to amount to anything until you learn to do what you're told.
Mm-hmm. It's a great lesson.
And that sounds harsh, like somebody's bossing you. But how many times you're in the military, you're a doctor, somebody says, hand me that scalp. I'm being serious.
Yep.
Give this person this medication. Hey, don't do such and such, Billy. You know, when we're not home, you know, you're not allowed to get in the alcohol or get in dad's car or take the keys or play around. I'm being serious.
Mm-hmm.
And people just don't do what they're told.
Yep.
You know, sometimes you just have to follow legitimate authority.
Sometimes you got to.
And, you know, with freedom comes responsibility.
Mm-hmm.
That's what this show is about. That's one of the words of wisdom from Ward. And I hope you guys didn't mind. I shared it with you. I remind myself about this kind of stuff.
Ward Cleaver to me and Mike Brady, I always say this, are the two greatest TV dads of all time.
Fantastic.
You know, like just, they're both just so tremendous and such wise words that you always got from those two characters, you know, that and the wonderful actors that played, you know, with Hugh Beaumont playing Ward Cleaver and Robert Reed, I think his name was.
Yeah, Robert Reed.
Reed, who played Mike Brady, just two wise characters and wonderful fathers and great lessons that you always learn throughout the shows from these, you know, two characters. And there's a million other great TV dads that are out there as well, you know, throughout time that we could go through. That would be a fun episode. We could do maybe an extra one day, the greatest TV dads of all time.
Yeah. A nice one.
Yeah. You know, I've done it on my other channel before, but there's some different things that you see, you know, I did it years ago and, you would see that, you know, your ideas and your mindset changes on them.
Yeah.
But I loved how Ward had to kind of stand his ground a little bit here.
Yeah.
And he did it in the right way.
Yeah.
And he had to.
It's tough being a dad. It's tough being a friend. It's tough being a teacher, as George Winslow knows, or a mom or a grandma, as Deborah, Barb, or somebody out there, all of you know out there, or just a good friend.
Yeah. Sometimes. It's just sometimes the way it's got to be.
Yep.
It's just sometimes the way it's got to be. Well, we hope everybody enjoyed this wonderful show tonight.
That's a goodie.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Oh, here I got some good comments here. Let's see. Barbara says, John Alton, the best TV dad. All right, John Alton. That is a big problem, especially kids won't do what they're asked to do many times.
Yeah.
100%.
And sometimes you're told to do something.
Walton.
And you have to do it.
Walton, yep. John Walton.
Oops. Oh, yeah, from Walton.
Yeah, she said that she misses it. Oops, John Walton.
Oh, yeah.
Walton Family. What a great show that was. I haven't seen that in ages.
The best.
Yeah. Another wonderful show. Well, everybody, we hope you enjoyed this episode. Come on back on Wednesday. We'll have another great episode.
The next episode is great.
Yeah. The State versus Beaver.
I didn't know I hadn't seen that in a while and I forgot it. Man, it's a goodie. Full of moral lessons, full of great character acting, some heart, you know, bring a tissue with you.
Yeah. I'm interested to see that one too. I kind of remember that one just a little bit, but it's been a hot minute since I've checked that one out too. I know it's like the motorized, he's got like the motorized engine in there or something like that. Bye, George. Great to see you tonight. Everybody, make sure you guys all hit the like button on this video, whether it's YouTube or whether it's on Facebook. You're watching, like and follow the page if you're watching on Facebook. Subscribe on YouTube and hit that notification so you get notified every single time. And yeah, I think that's just about it. Once again, it's also on audio. Check it out on audio if you'd like to as well. Absolutely. So we hope you guys enjoyed it, and we had a great time being out with you.
Have a hug of cake, and God bless everybody.
Amen to that. We will see you all on Wednesday for another great episode of The State versus Beaver, and we'll see you back here live next Saturday, as always, right here on the Leave It to Beaver podcast. So for Stan, I'm John. That's Ward. I'm Wally. Good night, guys. We're out of here, and we will see you guys again next week. Have a great rest of your weekend. And have a great start to your week, and have a great day whenever you're checking this out. God bless everybody. God bless you all too, Deborah. Thank you so much. And everybody that came out checking us out later, we really appreciate your support always. And we'll catch you guys again real soon. See you again right here on the Leave It to Beaver podcast.
Thank you. Bye-bye.